What's going on? I'm Kevin Hart, and we are back for season 6 of Cold as Balls. It gets bigger and it gets better. You put ice on me, I'll bust your You too. Hey.
Yeah.
What's up, man?
How are you?
Good to see you, dude.
Yeah.
Look at you. I'm good.
Yeah, right on.
My God, man, you look good. This is going to be great.
Here we go.
You can put it right there. Right hang here. Up on a hook.
All yep. All right.
How's retirement, man?
It's good. It's good. I thought I wouldn't have to do much more of this.
Really?
Yeah.
You thought you'd be done with it. Get in, we sit on the back.
Okay.
Chat it up for a little bit, then we slowly get into the cold tub.
I got to mentally prep a little.
You'll be all right. Oh, man.
Okay.
There you go. Come on, man.
It's just the beginning.
Guys. Come on, stop cheating. Sit on the back. Sit on the back, or you're going to make me get all the way in. Yeah, sit on the back. Yeah. Goodness gracious, you tried to jump the
gun. I thought we were going in.
Not yet. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome to Cold as Balls. I, of course, am your host, Kevin Hart. And today, I'm with royalty. A legend. Shaun White is in the building. You're retired now.
I'm pretty happy about it, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it weird?
You know, if it were a traditional sport like football or something, like, it's hard to, like, keep doing that sport. Snowboarding, I can still go snowboarding. Like, enjoy it.
Did you cry? Was it, like, an emotional?
Oh, for sure. I was trying not to, but I got to the bottom, and all my competitors are waiting there, and they were, like, telling me all these stories how I influenced their lives. That really got me.
Well, the crazy thing about you, you've been great the entire time.
When I started, there was no Olympics. Like, that wasn't even an option. Mm-hmm. X Games had just started, and it was completely different than what you see today. Mm-hmm. There were, like, really no future in it, and I just loved the sport.
You're a part of history. You're a part of f***ing history when it's attached to this sport. I heard, at the age 7, you had sponsors and then?
Yeah, well, that's what was wild is, like, they didn't even make kids' boards. My mom took me to the mountain. I was like, I gotta do this thing snowboarding. They rented me a board, but it was giant. And so my mom called Burton Snowboards and was like, my son, he snowboards. She's probably lying. Like, he kills it. You know, just so happens we're gonna make kids boards this next season. So why don't you, you know, stay in touch and we'll get him a board.
We share similarities in some things.
Oh, we do?
Yeah, because you said you were endorsed at the age 7.
Yeah.
Me too.
Oh.
Yeah.
What for?
All right, let's take a quick commercial break. White hand, please. Oh, yeah. This episode of Cold as Balls is brought to you by Old Spice, and of course, I got some new. Oh, it's time to talk about that Nourish with avocado oil. Ooh, it's got a lasting scent and plant-based hydration. Go get you some. White hand. Thank you, man. How old are you now, Sean?
35.
After retirement, do you look and go, God, I'm a little nuts.
Yeah, like I know now what's gonna happen if things go wrong, because it's happened and now I have that life experience.
Give me your scariest moments.
I was in New Zealand. I'm getting ready for my 4th Olympics. I'm having the best day ever. And I'm thinking, all right, today's the day I do this trick that I've been like procrastinating. And right away I take off. I know what's wrong. I'm like 20 feet in the air going, oh great, like this isn't good. And so I come down, I hit the wall, and then I bounce, and the wall's 22 feet. So I bounce to the bottom, and what broke my fall was my face. My forehead was split open.
God.
My lip was ripped, tongue was like hanging. And this is what kind of scared me, because I was like, how bad is it?
Well, you f*** yourself up bad, yeah. And you can't see it. You're just going off of everybody else's face.
Yeah.
Oh, sh-. Well, that right there, like, you don't want that. Oh, sh-.
How bad is it?
Oh, my God.
The wildest part is that I made a promise to myself that I wouldn't do that trick until it was perfect. And at this point, we're like 2 weeks from the Olympics and I'm having a meltdown. I haven't done the trick. I'm terrified to do it. I'm like, I'll just do it when I have to do it. So fast forward, we're at the Olympics. I'm sitting there going like, all right, it's now or never. I gotta do it. And I nailed it. And that was awesome. That was just like one of the highlights.
I am going to be honest and tell you that was probably one of the best stories
that
I've heard. All right, Sean, time for us to get in the tub a little more, okay? We just sit on a stool in the back. Oh, yeah. There you go, right?
That's good. That's it.
Right there.
There we go.
You had some surgeries too, right? You had open heart surgery.
Yeah.
You are a walking survivor, man.
Well, it's funny too, because I kind of hid that I had the heart surgeries for the first Olympics, because, you know, they grab onto things in the media, and I didn't want to be like, heart surgery miracle boy does whatever, you know what I mean? I'm like, I don't want that as my title.
My surgery miracle medical boy.
Yes. You can see the bit of the scar and the staples here. But I had what's called tetralogy of Fallot. I had like leaking valves and things.
What?
Holy.
Hello.
Is this for me?
What are you doing? You don't snowboard. And what are you doing? You damn sure don't snowboard. Just because you got the board. Damn. Stop it. Stop it. Shaun, I don't know if you noticed or not, but I dabble. I dabble on the mountains a little bit. Getting on the snow. You're pissing me off. Okay.
All right. In.
Okay. I know they call it the double black diamond. That's what I'm. What do you? Grow the fuck up. You hear me? This isn't even a snowball. It's not even a snowball. This is what you're doing with your spare time? Huh? Well, stop it. You in the sport, there has to be somebody that motivated you to get into it. There has to be somebody that acted as a mentor.
I would say it would be like Tony Hawk.
Ah.
I ran into him at the skate park. He lived in the same neighborhood as me. They opened up this awesome skate park at the YMCA, and he would be there all the time. And so I'd go there, and I had this fantasy that if, like, I just skated really well, he might come talk to me. He came up, introduced himself, asked me if I wanted to come to this, like, skateboarding demo with him. My mind's blown, and after that, just, like, we became friends, you know?
That's insane.
Yeah.
And he took a liking to you. By the way, one of the nicest guys and one of the funniest guys.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
I like that you guys are very similar. If it wasn't snowboarding, what else could it have been?
My dad wanted me to be a surfer. I'm named Shaun after Shaun Thompson, this like South African surfer.
Okay.
I'm like, okay, it was like his decision, right? And so whenever you push the kids into things, it's tough.
You basically, your dad is forcing you to surf.
Oh, it's tough. I'm picturing, when I look back, it's more of a grainy film that's playing out, and it was cold and it was storming, and he takes me to the beach and drags me out through the surf. And he's like, this is the wave. And it's a huge wave. And I'm thinking like, oh my God.
How old are you?
5 or 6.
God damn, Dad?
Yeah.
What do you mean? Like, 5 or 6? I thought you were saying 12.
He takes me down there, sends me down the wave. I go under, I try to get air. I get swirled again. Board hit me in the face. I'm like bleeding now. And I'm like, I hate you. That single tear, you know, he wanted it.
Is there another thing that you love too?
Oh. I fell in love with playing music. I won a guitar at a snowboard concert.
You got a band, don't you?
Yeah.
You had a band?
Well, I had one back in the day. It was like some friends from the neighborhood and stuff.
What was the name of your band?
It was called Bad Things.
Were you the lead singer?
No, I was like the lead guitar guy.
I love that every time you
I was in the background. Like
every time you say it, you do this right here. You get like a little twitch.
You gotta get that face gun, the like.
Where were you guys at with the World of One? Like, is that something that you were passionate about?
Kind of at one point, we put out like a little album and toured a little, and that was just the best part. What was wild about it is I had never done like a team sport. Snowboarding was like, okay, I do this, I do this. And with the team effort, it was crazy because it's like somebody's birthday and this going on. And then I'm like, wow, okay, this is hard to like get everybody on that same motivated, you know,
effort. Personalities.
Yeah.
That's dope, man.
I had a
group.
Okay.
We had one. It was a group called You Better Not. Like, I'm looking for you. I know you see me too. What you wanna do? I'm trying to. It's 7 days in a week, but I'm gonna sleep for 3. Cause I'm trying to. I was a virgin, so that was.
Everything was
on my mind. I know you know. It's your problem. All right. You need to relax. Sorry, Shaun. What are you talking about?
We gotta go in deeper.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. White hand. We're about to grab a stool. Just give him your stool.
Okay.
I know when we're supposed to go in. I'm the host of the show.
Oh, here we go.
Okay. I know. And I'll get it. Ooh. Give me a second. Hey. Get your hand out my ass. Bam. Back up. Back. Take it. Just take it. Go. Give it to white hand. Give it to white hand. He don't need your help. There ain't supposed to be 2 white hands back there. It's only 1. He over here trying to do too much. That's his problem. I named the hand after you.
Oh.
Yeah.
Thank you.
White hand. Miracle hand.
White hand.
What we call
him. Miracle white
hand. What happened to the hair? Why'd you cut it?
Oh, man. I bumped into Carrot Top in Las Vegas.
This is already funny.
It was amazing. And I was like, yeah, I'm thinking about maybe trimming the hair, you know? And he kind of gave me this look like, do it now before it's too late. Like, he's like, I'm stuck like this, but like, there's still time for you.
Yeah. So you cut it. What'd you do? What'd you do?
I ended up donating it. You can donate it to like charities that make wigs for
who's got the Shaun White wig?
I know.
Wait a minute.
Yep.
You son of a that beard. You showed up this season with a goddamn beard. You didn't have it before. You son of a ain't
that was for the children.
Come over here. Get next to Shaun. Let me see it. It's the same color and everything. Let me see it.
Oh, goodness.
Right there.
Is that?
Oh, my gosh, Shaun. Imagined? Well played. Well played. How much did you pay for it?
It does look nice, though.
Top dollar? All right, Shaun, we're going to play a little game right now, right?
Okay.
Basically, got to name two tricks, and then you got to make up one, and I got to tell you the one that is real, and I'll do the same for you. Called Two Tricks
Two Tricks and a Lie.
Yes.
First trick is a front side roast beef.
Ain't no goddamn roast beef. That's a lie.
That's a trick.
That's a trick? The f*** is that?
The worst trick.
Hold on. What? Back up! Roast beef. Bet that's roast the one that you would love to do. All you want to do is eat. Go ahead, Shaun.
It's a grab. It's where you grab between your legs on the back edge.
Okay, give me another one.
Switch. Revert 360.
Okay, give me one more. Come on.
Front side double cork. 1200.
Front side double cork 1200 is real. I've done it. The middle one isn't real. Because I would have done it.
More ice.
My turn. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna try.
All right. Tricks sound fake anyways.
I got them.
I gotta keep track.
Here you go, first one.
Yeah.
The double back twirl. Twirl top tip. I wanna f. And the other one is sliding handbag tuck tip. With a double dip. And the last one is the journey in the Which one of those is fake?
Hoping the last one's fake.
Nope.
Sure.
Nope. Journey in the is real. That's real. These are easy tricks. But what is not easy is accomplishing what you've accomplished. Okay, and we're talking about history. You know, don't fully leave the sport. You gotta go. You gotta keep your hands on these younger people, man, to the best of your ability. Will you stop? Stop it. Ladies and gentlemen. We learned some more stuff. And that's the even. So sick of you, man. You need to cut it out. I don't know why you would make me do that. Goodness gracious, Shaun. Sorry, I apologize, man. You made me do that. You made me do that. Huh? I didn't want to have to do the double trick, half pipe, double dip. Huh? Give me the goddamn boy. Come on, Shaun. You okay? Yeah, take that. You don't deserve it. You got it. Something coming.